doing okay?
Anybody else coming?
Yes.
Hello.
Hi, Pat.
Hi.
Oh, it's so nice to see everyone.
Yes.
Well, not quite. Where's Jill?
I'm coming. Here I am. Hello, Lady Children.
Hello.
Hello. We're all techie.
We were just remembering what we did when we did that first ever CD. Do you remember?
Absolutely. Out at Lanaiga. Yes.
Such fun.
It was fun.
Yeah. Without Tom, we wouldn't have been able to do it.
No.
No, absolutely.
Well, should we start singing?
Good idea.
We behave ourselves.
We're so pleased to welcome you today to a Songs of Praise chosen by the Monday Choir. We appreciate the encouragement given by the Reverend Lady Jane and the technical support of Rob and Jeff. It's almost a year since the Monday Choir last met to sing, but COVID has not quelled the enthusiasm of members. Stories and news have been shared online. However, it's not the same as singing together, learning new music, and then sharing our endeavours in aid of good causes. Singing together can be a huge pleasure, but hymns are special. The combination of poetry and music can calm, encourage, and excite us. Hymns help us to understand our amazing Creator God, the teaching and supreme love of Jesus, and the guiding power of the Holy Spirit.
Our first hymn is Lord of All Hopefulness and Lord of All Joy. It was chosen by Sylvia and myself. I love this hymn because the words are so appropriate with Jesus for all day and going into the evening, and the melody is very simple and lulling.
Our next hymn, For the Beauty of the Earth, was chosen by Carolyn Kay. In making her selection, Kay wrote, The words speak volumes, especially during lockdown, when the natural world has meant so much to us all.
We're all sad to hear that a founder member of our choir, Dilly Sibyl, died after a long battle with cancer. She was born in Talgarth and loved everything Welsh. Her favourite hymn was Cwm Rhondda, Guide Me, O Thou Lord, Great Redeemer.
Thank you.
Many of the choir have lost friends and family during this pandemic. Gloria and I have chosen Be Still My Soul. We have had to be still and reflect. Coming is a time for optimism. The harmonies in this song are really lovely.
Robert Herrick was a poet and a priest who lived in the time of Queen Elizabeth I. You may know some of his Christmas carols. For me, this poem expresses the way in which music can heal, can help sadness and disturbance with calm, beauty, and pleasure. The poem is called To Music. Music, thou queen of heaven, care-charming spell that strikes the stillness into hell. Thou tamest tigers and fierce storms that rise with thy soul-melting lullabies. Fall down, 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 down those chiming spires to charm our souls as thou enchantst our ears.
The hymn I've chosen is Great is Thy Faithfulness, and I chose it after much reflection because I think it expresses the much needed sentiment in these times of turmoil and change, uncertainty, loss and illness, because it speaks of God's enduring goodness and faithfulness to us all.
Thank you.
members of our choir have remembered singing hymns at school. Julia remembers, "Thou dost leave the throne and thy kingly crown." And Linda said, "Morning has broken. It cheers me up and gives us all hope for the future."
Loved the song Danny Boy. She remembers her mum often humming the tune because it made her happy.
Mm-hmm.
The next song, Let There Be Peace on Earth, is chosen by Alison. She was so disappointed I couldn't find it in any of my hymn books. She sent me this recording. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, our time together with singing and praise encourages everybody. We share the sadness for so many lives lost in the pandemic and pray for all who are lonely and the bereaved at this time. We thank you for the beauty and amazing variety in the natural world, which has been an inspiration for so many people. Father God, be with us all as we go forward, trusting in your loving support and of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Our final hymn, chosen by Mary, Judith, and Avril, is How Great Thou Art.
Thank you. sorry. I didn't mean to... Dawn, do you have some man behind you looking through the window?
Oh dear. It's Roger. Oh dear. It would be. He gets into everything.